Good morning, guys. I'm going to my course. Just been from the doctors. I've just met one of my fans through the hospital, Rachel Stubbs. Hello. She is lovely, bless her. I was just walking onto my course today because I thought I'd do some filming while I'm out and about. There's the old job centre where many rooms I used to sign on years ago. Very years ago, when my firm maiden name was Sledger. I've just been found out I've got hay fever now. Oh, more medication to take, guys. More medication to take. Jesus. Right, just nearly to my course now. This used to be Mails on Wheels years ago. There's the hospital, that tall building. And this is where I work. I work here. So I'm going to speak to guys later and do some more filming later on. Be cool, be happy, stay tuned. Tell rock doors 1, 2, 1. Love you guys. Right, it's good nearly good morning, afternoon-ish again. Hi guys, I'm back home. Oh, for long last. Just managed to get the stuff in the freezer for the barbecue on Thursday. Of course, I am going to enjoy myself with my new friends. My friend down the road, Jewels, who's coming round. I obviously don't mind me calling her Jewels. And my lad's coming, and hopefully I'm get a few more people to come. It would be nice if people did turn up, but if not, I'll still have a good time with a few people. I'm going to sort that shed out tomorrow. Yes, guys. Update on the breakup of me and Andy. I have found some gossip today. I was just walking downtown leisurely to go to Iceland, as you do. And I bumped into Shirley, Andrew's sister. Now, she told me that the police have told Andrew to move out. Now, according to my friends on Facebook, who I've been inboxing, and I told them the story of what he's been going around saying, that the police have been saying to him to move out. The police would not have told him to move out, right? That night, what happened? The police told him to stay in the house till I got back home, and I think it was to do with a certain person who lived behind us. I think somebody has told Andrew to move out. That's what I think. And I said to Shirley, I said, I still reckon that someone's told Andrew to move out. And she reckons that too. Oh, got the sunlight there. Yeah, and she reckons that too, guys. She totally does. So I'm looking forward to Thursday because I really want to chill out. Because I'm going to be doing the housework all day tomorrow. I'm going to get it all spotless if I can. Do a bit in each room. Starting with the kitchen because it's got messed up again. Near the back door, I've got to sort the recycled stuff out ready for Thursday. But if I can't, if they won't take it all, I'll have to put some in the bed. It's going to have to because it's like 2 weeks of it. Which I missed, and I missed the bin thing for 2 weeks ago, and so I've got that. I'm going to be doing chicken fillet, chicken, I'm going to be making chicken tikka tomorrow. I've got the tikka sauce up here. I'm going to make chicken tikka. And what's left, I'm going to use it for the barbecue, for the jacket potatoes and stuff, because I've just carried 2 bags of potatoes all the way back in from up here, which was a bit of a struggle, and it was literally a bit of a struggle. So today I am making beef burgers, little beef burgers. I fancy three today because I'm really hungry. Really hungry. Baked beans and chips. I'm going to have some chips with it because that's what I fancy today. I don't normally fancy beef burger and I just fancy it. Because of the walking I've done today, it's given me a little bit of appetite. So, like I say, to update on me and Andrew, like I say, I don't think the police have told him to move out. Even if I did ring the police and said, that night that you came to my house, did you tell my lad to move out? If they said no, I would believe them. Because the police don't lie. The police do not lie. They are there to tell the truth. They are there to explain the situation. They are there to help you. They would not tell that person to move out. Am I correct? Because if I am correct, I want to know. And at least there's a closure on me. At least there's a closure. And I told Shirley about my new lad, and she's totally fine with it. And I said I've only met since Saturday, and we just hit off really fine. And, you know, by the end of the day, life's too short, guys. It is really too short. I mean, I just found out a mate of mine yesterday died, called Jungle, and it did knock me a six for the sense, as they say, and I've been really upset about it for the last few days. So, guys, I have hay fever. That's why my throat's sore. That's why my nose is blocked. And I didn't know hay fever could do all this to you. I'm on medication for it. Oh, God, whatever next, I tell you. Whatever bloody next with me. You need to shake me up and upside down, man. I don't know if anyone could do that, like, shake me up upside down. Oh, God. But, yeah, I've seen two friends of mine from Facebook. Rachel Stubbs. Hello, Rachel. I think I said hello to you before on my other video. And another lass called Kirsty. Thank you for talking to us. Remember, if you want to add me, well, Rachel's already added me, but add me on my new account. Because of my other accounts, I can't forget, I've got my passwords and stuff. So yeah, and tomorrow, I'm going to get that yard sorted. I'm going to try and fix the hose pipe if I can. Get that yard sorted. I need my dad to pick up them stones. Take them away. So make the yard a little bit bigger so I can get the barbecue towards where the shed is. Move my conifer. Gonna move my conifer over here, I think, in this corner. Because I think it'll look better in that corner. And it's still growing, that conifer. It's surprising it's still growing because it's like dead in the on the bottom part. So yeah, I'm gonna try and organise me yard a bit better. Get the deck chairs out and everything for ready for Thursday. Sort my deck chairs out, give them a wipe, give them a clean, as you do. So, yeah, and I'll be organised. I will be organised. Right, guys. I will speak to you guys later. I feel really good about what I've been told. And that's what you need to know. When you've been in a breakup, you need to know some things and some things you don't. But life goes on. So, be cool, be happy, stay tuned, tell spells, rock your dudes, 1, 2, 1. Love you guys. Guys, I just want to show you the front room. Well, not the front room, the spare room. What I've done. Just basically, I've tidied up to that bit. And this is just my washing. Because this drawer doesn't fit in my bed for some reason now. So I think the runners have gone on it. So I'm just leaving my clothes in here. So I'm just using it as a laundry room. That's rubbish, that needs to go. That needs to go apart from a belt. Well, actually, yeah, that's rubbish because it's an old belt. And my scarf. And look, on the window side, it does look a bit better and bigger. I think. Right, I'll start from the door. It does look better already. So when the inspection's over, I'm going to try and move the bed over to that side. Put that wardrobe in that corner. Try and move the big wardrobe over to here. If it'll fit in that corner. So at some point, I'm not doing it like sort of straight away. It's going to like give it time. Just like give the room, change the room a little bit. And so this is to be like my guest room. So I'm going to need a new quilt cover for it. So I'm going to have to get some of them. And I've just finished sorting in here. What a day today, guys. What a day. I'm just exhausted from everything about health-wise and doing the house. And I've got a lot to do tomorrow. I know that. I've got to clean the shed out. My dad's coming in the morning to move the rocks. Because I really wanted the rocks out the way in case anybody falls over them. And I don't want them in my garden yard anyway, so it's dangerous. Plus, I'm going to get my dad to try and fix my hose pipe so I can give the yard a good wash down tomorrow, clean the rabbit out, clean the shed out, find the barbecue stuff, which I need for Thursday, wash the barbecue out. I've got that to do tomorrow. Then I've got to clean the front room out, hoover it up. Then I've got to clean the pets out as well. And then I've got to make my dinner, which is going to be chicken tikka. So I've got quite a busy day tomorrow, plus washing in between. So I've got washing to do again, because I'm finding like little bits to wash. And that I'm going to wash my net curtains as well. So it's like all the houses are all ready for the inspection soon. So it's really just the kitchen, really, because that is the big job. Well, the kitchen is the biggest room in the house, and sometimes it takes about 2 or 3 days to clean it. And I'll just potter along doing it bit by bit, because I'll do the washing up in the morning when I get up. So that basically is job to do anyway. So yeah, this is just like an update on my final day, guys, and I'm looking forward to seeing my lad on Thursday. And I'm just missing his cuddles, really. And you'll get a chance to see him if he's not camera shy. But if he is a bit camera shy, maybe in time you will get to see him. I don't think he is camera shy. I think he's just hiding it. So, right, I'll speak to you guys later. Be cool, be happy, stay tuned, tell us bells, rock dudes, 1, 2, 1. Love you guys.